TIFU by telling my friend I have feelings for her. My friend, 28F, and I, 29 meters, met about 10 years ago from a mutual friend's party. At the time she had a BF and I was just starting a relationship. Somehow that night we met. We clicked right away and we formed a very good friendship. We would communicate often and would get together with our partners. I can say we've gotten pretty close through the years. During these 10 years we've been friends. We both have been through a few relationships and we've always been there to console one another. When things didn't work out for each other, I split from my last GF about a year ago and my friend had also just had a breakup possibly a couple weeks before that. This past year we have spent so much more time together than we've ever had before. Working out together. Breakfast, lunch, dinners. Going out for drinks or movies. Weekend getaways, etc. I never considered making a move since I truly enjoy the friendship we have. Nor has she ever given me any signs of wanting to make a move. In the past, she made a comment when I was going through one of my breakups about how I deserved someone better than the girl I was dating at the time, and also said that she wouldn't date me because she wasn't good enough for me either. A few months ago we were discussing future plans and what we are looking for in a partner, and we both basically said the same thing we're looking for, and she jokingly said, "We're probably soulmates and we don't know it." In the past 2 months the idea of us being more than friends has crossed my mind so often that I've been contemplating telling her about it. Last month she invited me as her plus one at one of her work events in New York, which took place 2 weeks ago. I decided to tell her what I was feeling when we were on our walk back to the hotel after an event. She told me that although we have such a great friendship and she believes we would give it our best to make it the best relationship, she only sees me as a friend and she doesn't want anything more than that. I told her I respected her decision and hoped that this wouldn't change things between us. I made sure not to act weird or different the rest of the trip and kept things as they were, even though I was disappointed and ashamed inside. We returned back to our city earlier in the week and honestly we have not communicated much at all. I'm starting to think making my confession was a mistake and I wish I could take that moment back. I fear that I may have possibly pushed a great friend away. TLDR. I told my friend of 10 years I have feelings for her and she said no. Now we haven't talked in a few days and I'm regretting having told her how I felt. That's rough, man, but you shot your shot. Time to move on. Your friendship will most likely recover, but it'll take time. I went through something similar in that I had a close guy friend with feelings for me and I had to reject him. It did take some time. But now we are friends and he even comes to game nights with me and my husband. We are not as close as we once were. But we settled into a new type of friendship. That is what you need to do. Any guy or girl you two might get involved with wouldn't be comfortable with the type of friendship you two had. So that already had an expiration date on it. So move on and know that if you both want it, your friendship can still continue, but maybe on a more restrained basis. The gym welcomes you, brother. I was in your shoes once. Eventually, we became friends again and we both found our own partners. It stings and it's so hard, but you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Give both of you time. Are you still willing to be friends? If so, give her a bit of time and make sure she knows. And you mean, Hat, you want to remain friends and you won't make any moves. I feel you. When I was around 22, a very good friend of mine was just broke up with their ex-partner. We started talking more and eventually became FWB. We thought we were doing everything right. We established firm boundaries when it came to sex. Discussed how we'd approach everything if one or both of us wasn't into it or when we'd eventually stop. She emphasized how important how trust and truth was to her. So no matter what happens, we'd always be friends and we'd always be honest. But the sex wasn't just sex. It was very emotionally intimate. We crossed lines FWB shouldn't. After the fact, she kept going as if things were normal. She wanted to keep up the sexual relationship. But I was honest. I told her I caught feelings. Either this becomes a relationship, or it stops. No in between. She told me she wishes I would have never said anything. She wished I would have lied to her. We're not talking anymore. It's hard to lose a friend, especially one who you deeply care about. It's worse when you thought you were doing everything right, only to realize in hindsight that you messed up, that she messed up. I will take responsibility for what I have done. If I must fall, I will rise each time a better man. Brandon Sanderson. A true friend won't deliberately step on your heart and crush it, and especially not when you are being vulnerable. Give her some time and you will see that everything will be fine in the end. Being honest with her and more importantly yourself is not foo. If you hadn't spoken up, you'd regret it eventually. Getting these feelings out, hearing the results, good or bad, helps you move on with life. You're no longer stuck in the mental treadmill of, does she or doesn't she? Maybe you have a friend. Maybe you don't. What you do have is an answer. Maybe you never said anything and 5 years from now you post a TIFU about how you both missed years of a relationship because neither of you wanted to speak up. She is probably taking some time to be distant to help emphasize what she said to you. Many men will just keep pushing and pushing and pushing, or become angry and even threatening. She may be worried that that will happen with you. If the lack of communication goes on for weeks, you might send a short message to the point that you meant it when you said you want to remain platonic and only platonic friends. You value her friendship and let you know if or when she is ready to pick the friendship back up. Most likely your admission made her re-examine recent events with you, and she might be realizing that the two of you were maybe getting a little too close, comfortable with each other as substitutes for real partners. This is important because while it doesn't matter what anyone else thinks about your relationship, it can highlight that you're both maybe not on the same wavelength when it comes to the newfound closeness, and could lead to hurt feelings on one or both sides. Reassure her you're still very interested in a completely platonic friendship, but be prepared to give her time, space to process all this. What you told her about respecting her decision is good, but you need to demonstrate this through action as well. She'll talk to you when she's ready. As others have said, she may be keeping distance to send the message she meant what she said. But it's also possible she's trying to let you have distance to get perspective and try to let your feelings realign. I was in a similar situation once where we spent all our time together. Only after I confessed, she kept calling and coming over every day, and I wasn't quite strong enough to break off for a while. In the end, things blew up and we haven't talked for almost 20 years. I have often thought that if I had taken some time away, I could have moved past it and kept the friendship. If she is that aware of your feelings to the point she is letting you have this time, she is a true friend. Wait for a while, things will get better. I really hope she comes back to you and accepts your proposal. Good luck. You've done everything right. If you don't speak your mind, you'll regret it for the rest of your life. You did it. It didn't pan out, but at least you know the outcome of bringing it up. I've been thinking about telling my friend that I want to be more than friends, but this is the third post in my feed in a row about things getting screwed up after confessing feelings to a friend. I think the universe is trying to tell me something. Your friend is probably unsure how to proceed in a fashion that makes it clear she only wants friendship from you. An unfortunate reality, probably for everyone, but definitely definitely experienced by women, is that others confuse just being nice with being lead on. Your friend doesn't want to lead you on. However, it is very easy for any behavior that is even remotely perceived as friendly to be misinterpreted in sending mixed signals and doing exactly what she wants to avoid. It is way easier just to avoid someone for a few weeks in an attempt to try to mitigate risk of this. Just to give an example of how common this is, I broke up with a guy. We establish we will remain friends. I do not text him for a few days. He gets angry and unfriends me from Facebook. I ask him what gives. He accuses me of ghosting him. It has only been 2 days. I tell him I was giving him space, so it didn't seem like I was toying with him after breaking up with him. He says he is an adult and can tell the difference. I say okay. Text him the next day about something. Exchange a few messages. He asks if I want to come over to fool around. I say fooling around would definitely send mixed signals I do not want to send. He proceeds to say I should not have spent all day flirting with him if I didn't want to send mixed signals. I was in no way flirting. Literally talked about groceries I needed to pick up. Even though he fully stated in advance of me messaging him that he understood I was not messaging him to engage in any sexual or romantic behavior, he still went on to ignore everything I had told him and interpret 100% non-sexual text messages as messages that were leading him on. Saving your friendship is easy. Don't be weird. Take what your friend has said at face value. She isn't interested in you that way. If you want to remain friends, recognize that it is really to remain friends. There isn't going to be a romantic relationship. There is no unspoken promise that she is making to you by remaining friends. She isn't secretly sending a signal that one day you will be more than friends. If you stay friends with her now and she starts dating another guy and marries him, she hasn't done you dirty or misled you in any way. Your friendship will be just fine if you don't have a hidden agenda for it and understand that it is only a friendship. You shot your shots and missed. Try messaging her back again and say thanks for giving you a proper answer and hope you can still be friends. I had a similar situation, and it was awkward any first, but no walls can withstand the power of memes. Since my friend is short, I always send memes about short people. Now you've got to move on. Or else your nature as a man will keep torturing you whenever you interact with her. Because you'll be forever a friend while that is not what you want. Moving on also allows you to find someone else that can truly be your partner. And I can't possibly say in words how much better it would be than the situation you are in right now. Just don't reach out to her anymore. And if she does, say it clearly you don't want to be just a friend. My man, this is a classic, I wish I could find someone like you, scenario even though you're completely available. She's playing games. Walk away. My dude, I'm sorry but she isn't attracted to you. I am in a similar boat right now and probably know how you feel. Albeit not with a 10-yo friend. And we were flirting for a while. I hope that we are in the cooling off period and hope it will at least partially return to the pre-discussion relationship. It will be all good in the end. At least you shot your shot. Imagine me regretting never having using the opportunity I was given and miserable now as it keep bouncing around my brain many years later and crops up at the most inopportune moments.
If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlists full of similar content. Epic Aracast is like doom scrolling for your ears. Please like, share, and subscribe.